Okay, now. So again, good morning, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our webinar session number 3 for post-processing. Today I add three topics or two topics at the end on the agenda. So first, a short introduction and recap of the last session, the last time. Then I want to show you a little bit of the best practice inspect tool and debugging. And by the way, I have a great idea in the morning when I drive to work, and will try out it live today, but I go in detail later to that. After that, I want to show you a prototype of converting a post builder to post configurator post. It's still a prototype, but what my intention today is also from you to get some feedback. What is really important for you if we're talking from converting a post builder to post configurator, and hope we will have some really good discussions for that, and also feedback what is needed, and for sure at the end question answer the open discussions over all topics, other topics you have in mind. And yeah, today I will not do a survey like the last time, but for any feedback. So please, also if you have questions, because this session today will be, especially for the inspect tools, will be very technical. So if you have questions, interrupt me directly if there's some misunderstanding or whatever. And on the other side, this video is recorded as every time, so you can also retake the things after the session. Just try it out on yourself, maybe, but we will see. Okay. So first, short recap last session. So as every time. You for those who are not knowing, we have this NXCam post-processor group. In this post-processor group, there's the first topics is webinar planning, and inside of that one you will also find the session 1 and 2, and I will add the session from today after this meeting. So last time we talked about this post builder post configurator future, the roadmap, the comparison between the tools, and this best practice layer handling, how you can use it, which value you get out of this to use this layer handling. We're still working on the layer manager and development, which will be released in the near future. At the end, thank you for all for your feedback, also in the survey there. So I did just pick out the topics of this inspect tool at the end, and to convert the post builder to post configurator. Next session I will be talking about cycle-actian-node and VXS turning, but doesn't matter for today. So yeah, maybe any questions from the last session somebody have in mind? Okay, then let's go into the topic of inspect tool. So I don't prepare slides for that. I will do all the things live in the system today. So feel free to interrupt and discuss between the steps. In general, inspect tools, that is the main tool in post configurator to customize the post processor. We enhance this in the last version, so I work currently on 1863 version. And in the debugging group, you have this option, show inspect tool. When you switch this on, by the way, that is the only property where you don't have to save the post processor to get the inspect tool open. Background is, or the value of that, that it is not saved in the post processor. That means if I now click the save button, then it will be saved. And when you open the next time the post configurator, it is automatically switched on. So for debugging, it's not needed to save. Just select an operation, switch on the property, and say post process. What you then get is this inspect tool window. And I think in the first session or the second session, I think in the first session I showed a little bit of the inspect tool. Short recap of that inspect tool, you have multiple informations. At the end, you have three different views. So that means I, as a post-processor developer, want to look from the NC code, for example. That means if I switch on to the NC output, I see all the NC code, which is outputted by the post-processor, and I can go to the line, for example, to the tool change here, and get additional information. The additional information is from which MOM event this is produced or created, and what is the buffer behind it. Buffer, I will tell in a second, multiple additional things. On the other side, you get an overview about all the variables which are available in the MOM event or changed in this MOM event. For example, also nice functionality. You can just click it and say copy variable name to clipboard so you don't have to keep it in mind or whatever. Nice functionality. Additionally on that, you have a search. So means if you search for a MOM variable, like let us use MOM underscore tool underscore name, and you get automatically a list where this MOM variable is inside. So that means you see, for example, here this is in the buffer events. So if I click it, then it will automatically change the view, will go to the buffer where it is called, and it's automatically selected in the information window here. So, okay, somebody wait. Somebody else don't hear me? Okay, then sorry, Joel. Then maybe you have to re-listen the recording on that point. As I said, so it's automatically selected. You jump directly to the buffer, or if you want to go to the MOM event, for example, it's let us search the list a little bit here. Like here, okay, here it's empty. So you get at the end all the results where it occurs. You can also use this find next, and it will automatically jump through the events. And so you can go step by step searching for the variable, take a look what was changed or where it was changed. The second view, to come back to the views here, empty the search, MOM events view, that means that is the view of the created MOM events from NX Core here. So as you know, we start with the part attributes, start of program, then we have the start of or the machine mode operator, and so on. So this is it's at the end it's the same as I mentioned in the first and second meeting, it's the same underlying MOM architecture for Post Configurator or for Post Builder. It's the same, but the inspect tool visualize the things here. From the MOM events, if you are interested in all informations or just for MOM variables, then this view is very good. I personally work the most time with the NC output view, and additionally on that with the buffer view. The buffer view, that is, let's go over to that. That is at the end the view where you really do your customization or which you use for customization of the post processor. You have multiple additional commands which are called in a MOM event. So, for example, let us do it with the MOM first tool. So, when I click the MOM first tool, that is the origin MOM event generated by NX Core. And in the libraries of the post processor itself, we have additional what we call entry points, or at the end, it's a buffer where you can add additional customization. So, for example, we have you see it here this MOM tool change lib MOM tool change lib entry start. Then an additional, which is currently empty. Also, this is empty because it not generate any output. And for example, the MOM tool change itself. When I click on that, you have the plus here. Can expand it. And this, for example, generates output. It generates a T command with a message, 12 offs, and a super move, which is defined in the tool change itself. After that, we have an additional buffer. That is the MOM tool change lib entry end. That means this is called after this tool change. So if I want to do any customization here, for example, I want to add something before my tool change because maybe I use a different simulation system or I need some additional information for the simulation driver. What you then normally do, you can directly use this buffer, or I can also use this buffer to extend it, or I can use this buffer to extend it. This is something you have to decide. Normally, this lib entry start points and this lib entry end points. This is the first customization and the last customization when you want to customize something, for example, in the tool change. That means really at the beginning or really at the end. To make it easy, and now that is the way how it works, how to change it. You see on the right side, you get an information and you get a pre-selection of buffer commands. Those buffer commands can be append, prepend, insert, remove, replace, or move. And I think it's self-explained. So if I append something, then it will execute it at the end of this buffer. If I prepend something, it will be executed directly with the buffer call at the end. So let us say we prepend something here. And now we have to do our customization, right? So, and this is normally done by TCL. In this point, let's say, okay, we prepend something. You have two additional buttons here. The one is show the command buffer. That only means it will be shown the created command in the listing window. That means this is a command, libge command buffer added prepend. MOM tool change lib, MOM tool change lib entry start, and then code and tag. If you use an external editor, which I not recommend, you can do it and copy it from here. Or now I just say, okay, copy to clipboard, move this away of this window, open my TCL file, and insert it. So, and this is important to know, you don't have to really take care of all this before here, what is selected. You only have to take care of this code and the tag. The code is that what you want to execute, like I want to do a MOM do template, I want to just simple writing MOM output literal. And the tag is a unique identifier that you can also change this again in a different layer, for example. So let's do it shortly here. That means open bracket, just using a simple MOM output literal here. Close. Then we need a close bracket and our tag that is a unique identifier. I personally like it to write it in this case. And then say, okay, that is my tag. So to the tag, I will tell you in a second some additional thing. So now click OK and post-process again and see if we have some addition, if we have our additional output. Wait, where's my listing window? There it is. So we see now it was executed before our tool change. In the NC code, I have this additional line, whatever I want to output here. I think this doesn't matter. And when I now go back to the buffer events view, go to the MOM first tool, you see now this MOM tool change lib buffer have also this plus sign. I can expand it. And this is the output we generated. So, and In the information, now you see, okay, I have current tags, this is my tag. That is what is now the actual way how it's produced and C output. The standard one is this at default entry, that is because it's empty. Okay. So at the end, that is the basic message of it. You can modify everything in Post Configurator. Because every output is created from the standard libraries inside of a buffer. That means if I click, for example, this superset home, you see the buffer ID and you can change it. I can also remove output. If I want, I can remove this superset home D0. But now this is a really important point you have to think about. Because, you know, we have a lot of functionality which is controlled by properties in Post Configurator. And to decide what is really output by a property, what is output only by TCL, there's one indicator you should check first. If there is a command which is named like this lib return, so something concerning with lib, then this is normally controlled by a property itself. That means in this case, this lib return move access home set or after the tool change, go to the UI and let us first check before we do really customization with TCL. Maybe let's first check with something with tool change. Means I use the search here. Inch, let's take a look what we have here. We have a lot of templates. Tool change, tool change, tool change. What I know searching is more like in the additional emotions. So let us go to emotions. And for example, you see, okay, in the return before first tool change pause, we have currently a custom procedure. It's a trough off. It's a set return move and then this tool change return home command. So what I want to say before you really starting to directly add TCL customization, you should generally first check if this maybe is controlled by a property. What is in the most cases, especially for approach motions, for positioning motions, for before a tool change, after a tool change, before the MCS changed, after the MCS changed, all those things. First, take a look in the properties, and then if you don't really find anything, use the TCL implementation. So let's coming back to my idea from the morning when I drive to work here. I mentioned before, maybe I mean every time you want to customize a post process or wait, let me start in a different way. So now you see I have here Post Builder open, and there's one really nice thing in Post Builder that is also the visualization directly in the UI. So that means, for example, you have this operation start sequence, you have the start of path, and you see all the custom commands, which is very similar to the inspect tool, by the way. But in the inspect tool, you get much more information what is called. So when I develop post processors, and that is what I was thinking in the morning, maybe I don't want to search all the time for the buffer. Okay, which buffer I have to change? Have I where? For example, I want to add something sometimes before the tool change, something sometimes after, well, after the tool change. I don't want to open all the time the inspect tool, search for the buffer, copy it, extend it, and so on. I wanted to have it easily in the UI directly. So let me show you the approach of that. What we need for that, it's I will create a small group here. Let us name it Rapid Customizing. And inside of this group, I will visualize this buffers from the inspector. So to do that, I open the service file. Let me remove, for example, this one here. And now, as I said before, just let me typing and I will try to explain all the things. And you can relook this video and try to maybe on your own. But when I finished it in the morning, I tried it in the morning. I find it very, very cool to be honest. So what I have to do, I need first a UI object that we can create the structure in the tree here. So let me name it SPLM tree. Inside of this tree, I need a node. This is my UI node. That is my SPLM root node. Let me name it Inside of this node, I need a subgroup. New UI node again. That is SPLM node. So the parent of this node, like this debugging, so debugging is a child of miscellaneous. So my SPLM node is a child of SPLM root. Means copy that. That's the UI parent here. And let us name this one. It's rapid customizing. And inside of that, I need a group. So that is a group. SPL rapid group. The parent of this one is the SPLM node. And inside of that one, I need an additional group. And this group, let us name it my SPLM start of program group. Like similar to what we have in PostBuilder, we have in the program start sequencer. So this name is start program, and the parent of that is the SPLM rapid group. And let me directly do a second one. We need a second group that is named SPLM tool change group, for example. Tool change. And also this parent is the SPLM rapid group. And the name, it's will change. That means first I create the structure now. Now I create three properties inside of that. For that I need a new object again. That are my SPLM rapid properties. So, and inside of those I create a new, and now that's the point, a new command block property. So with this command block property, let me name it, that is, let me shorten it, SOP for start of program, before. So I want to specify a value here. And the standard value should be empty, or maybe, yeah, let's keep it empty. And this is the property for customization before start of program. And important, the parent that it will appears in the UI, that is my SPLM start of program. And now I need the same because I want directly an additional point for the end of program. So copy this one, paste it, and that is my start of program after. By the way, this is a work you do one time. So start of program after. And in the UI, it should be not before now, it should be after. Okay, so let's first Check. Wait. One last one for the tool change. I will do the same. The TCL details. So that means that is a property for the tool change. Tool change before. And that is customization before tool change. And for sure, the group is now not start of program. This one is the group for the tool change. Let's first check if there are any issues. So now I have a new group here, SPN, Rapid Customizing. In this group, okay, I forget the name. Inside of this group, I now have Start of Program and Tool Change group, like similar to what you have in PostBuilder. And now you can add additional things like what auto tool change event, like MSys event, whatever. The point is here, now I have a customization block inside of it. That means I can now say, okay, I want to do something here like mom output literal before start of program. I want to do some similar here after start of program. The one thing is I have defined it in the user interface now here. The other thing is I have to call this, right? And to do that, I need one time the inspect tool now, because I have to identify the correct buffer to add the customization of this block, what I now write inside of it, that this will automatically output in the NC code. So means let me post process again. Now we use the inspect tool first functionality one times again. Where we have the one start of program. That is what I mean. That is the end buffer, and we have the start buffer here. So this start buffer. Now in general, in this start buffer, we want to execute our customization of the user interface. That means I copy this one, go back to my TCL, and now add this buffer command. And now instead of hard coding something in the buffer command here, wrong one, sorry. Let us name it with the tag rapid. Start before, that is a unique identifier. And what I said, instead of doing a mom output literal, whatever, we execute now the content of this property. And for that, there is a command. You can find it in the NX help. Let me just showing it shortly. You can go in manufacturing. Post configurator, library commands, and in the lib general, there's a command that is named libconf do prop custom proc. This is a standard command which will execute the content of this UI interface. So you have all the time an example. Maybe just copying it. At the end, there's a description that expects the property name, and then it will execute the content of that. So let me copy it. So now we need the property, the object name and the property name. So the object name is this SPLM rapid properties. Paste this. And in the case of mom start of program lib entry start, we want to execute the property or the content of this UI element. That means this is the start of program before. So click OK, post process, and let's check the output. And now we have it. We have our before start of program. Let me just double check if I change this to something. Save, post process again. And now it's before start of program something. So that means now I can reuse this all the time. I don't have to create all the things again and again and again. I just create me this like in a layer, for example. Create it in a layer. And now without using really the inspect tool, I need it for the initial to set up those things here, right? But now, even if I want to do a simple demo, if I want to easily change something, I can change it directly. I can also now call procedures here, whatever. It's TCL at the end behind it. Okay, so and yeah, at the same, you can now do the same for the end of after start of program. Let us do that before we go over to the next topic. So for that, for sure you can now switch on the inspect tool again, search for the buffer what you want to change. I make it a little bit easier for me now. Copy the existing one here because the event is the same. It's a mom start of program lib, but it's not the start. It's now the end point of it, and I want to execute not the SOP before, I want to execute the SOP. And one good tip here is not try to write the things all the time again, especially if you copy the properties name or group names. Just double click it, copy it, and paste it. Makes the life really much easier. Instead of searching for case-sensitive problems. Let us check finally. Post-process again. So and now you see in the NC output, this is our before entry point and that is our after entry point. That means now I can create a standard set of customization points and simply change it in the UI then. Not needed to search all the things. Because, I mean, what is the common workflow at the end? Normally you change things in the start of a path, you change things in the mom first tool. Maybe you change things in the mom initial move before the first mom initial move or in the end of path. So that means you have a standard set of 10 properties where you easily can customize directly. And you are done, and that will be very time saving from my perspective. Okay. First, any questions until this point? Any other comments or remarks you maybe have?
I have some remarks, but it's in general about general conception, and I'm
Okay, yeah, but sure, that's.
suppose so I suppose it would be better to discuss about it at the end.
Okay, then yeah, let's discuss this point at the end. So, if there are no questions currently to this inspect tool or how to customize the things, I mean, there's one I provide this also in the slide. It's just this is the only slide I added today. It's how to read a buffer. If you're interested in the technical details behind it, really, it's just the buffer name, so the command which we called in TCL, it's the procedure which is called in the background. The third one is the buffer name itself, so must be unique. You can define your own buffers if you like. The fourth, that is what we did here, that is we call a procedure, we call execution code. And the fifth one, that is some tag. So that means a unique identifier inside of a post processor, because with the tag you can easily remove things. Maybe yeah, just let me finish with that one to remove things with the inspect tool. So for example, we have this tool change here, And we have multiple lines here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. And you see it's have multiple tags here. It have a tool change tag, it have a tool change init, a spindle init set feed pywarm tag. When I now click on this one, on this line, it's a tool change. That is a tool change. Okay, they are all from the tool change directly tag, and the other ones are only execution of code. That means they not really produce output, but they are execute code. So spindle init means it just sets the initial spindle access and so on, or sets the feed params. Like if I have parametric feed, if I have normal feed. If I want to remove something here, like this, I mean, make no sense to the tool change, for example, then I just can say, okay, remove. You use the tag you want to remove, this tool change, copy it to clipboard. Then you go DSL, and that's it. That means now click OK. If I post process again, even if it makes no sense, I don't have any tool change command now. So it's gone. So that is, for example, you can easily remove, but it's not lost in the libraries, it's still there. It's just because I remove this output tag. And that is really one thing you can take a lot of advantage because you can also dynamically change it during the runtime. That means in one case I want to output the tag or this tool change, in a different case I don't want output the tool change, whatever. So then you can put it in a if command, switch command, whatever, and change the buffer dynamically during the runtime. That is really one thing, one big advantage and value you have here. Okay, then if there are no more questions, let's go over to the second topic. That is the prototype of converting a post builder processor to post configurator. There's one question. Is inspector limited to a number of lines? No, it's not limited to a number of lines. So converting. This is a topic I think if you have a big library of existing post processors, I totally agree to the fact that it's if you now maybe starting with post configurator, you don't want to work with two different tools. You want to maybe have the same structure, you want to have similar structure. You maybe want easily convert an existing post processor into post configurator. So to be totally honest, that's difficult. That's very difficult because the structure at the end with all these buffer commands, with the customization you maybe did in your post processor, it's difficult to say I convert this post processor into a post configurator structure. For example, just to give you one very good example, kinematic. Post configurator contains a lot of how to calculate the correct values, and this is also feedback we get from services, from partners, that calculation of the coordinates, that is really very good in post configurator. You don't have to really take care of that if you are working with Cycle 800, if you work with Plainwood swiveling, TCPM modes, different modes of that. The calculation of the values, you don't have to really take care. In post-build in the past, sometimes you have to take care on that and this situation, then you have to rewrite all these Mumpkin variables and so on. This is one of the major problems. That means if I just copy the TCL of a post-builder in my post-configurator commands, I will overwrite the functionality of post-configurator and I still have the same problems as before. So I cannot take advantage of that. So one idea or one second point, that's also one thing, and then I will show the prototype first. I have a customer who's strongly working with UDEs, or I have a huge set of UDEs. You don't want to rewrite them all again in post configurator. You don't want to go in the TCL file. You don't want to search for the things and copy it and copy it. That is, from my perspective, time wasting, that make no sense, and you don't have a value. Let me show the prototype first. And so it's at the end, it's the idea here is, it's not finally decided, also to be honest. The idea is maybe to share this tool. It's an NX-Open application at the end. We don't want to have such a functionality directly in NX because it make no not really sense. If you develop this feature in NX Core directly, it make it difficult. It make it we maintaining is very complicated, and we want to know a lot of issues maybe. So the idea is to have more like an open source application for everyone, which we won't provide about the forum or whatever, and people can use it, people can extend it, or we work all together on that to make it running, and that is what I have more in mind. So let me start the NX Open application. It's very simple first. So you have at the end a checklist. It's like a wizard. So the first step, I need the information from the processor I want to convert. So let's go one step forward, and I have to select a post processor. Let me show it today with two post processors. The one is from a customer project from my side a few years ago, and from PostBuilder, very high customized with multiple UDEs and automation inside of it. And the other one, let me first do that. That is a standard GTEC post, like for example this FANUC MIL 5 table C kinematic. So what I have to do, I have to select the PUI file, open that, and now this is loaded in a TCL interpreter in the background, and you get some general information. In this case, because this was created, I think, Origin 1 in version 3 of PostBuilder, I don't know. You get the post name. There was not the information of the controller type, but I have the information of the unit, and I have the description files, which definition file belongs to this post processor, which TCL file. So, next step, because I don't have the controller information here, that is also one really strange thing in this case, because it's an older PostBuilder processor. Now I have to select, okay, the controller. I mean, for sure, you can maybe have some convention of the naming. Okay, it's containing FANUCs, and I can pre-select the FANUC one, for example. What you see now here, these are the controllers from the current NX session. That means this is from NX 1863. If you do that in, for example, NX 12 or NX 11, you will see maybe not the Okuma controllers, whatever. But remember, best practice is to develop a post processor, use the latest version, and then you are fine. At the end, I know it's a FANUC one, so select it, and now this is the important step here, the kinematics. I can say I want to keep the defined kinematics from the PostBuilder. That means like fourth access vector, fifth access vector, fifth access point, fourth access point, the direction of the spindle axis, and so on. Means if I keep this settings, I would not expect any difference from the coordinates output or the swiveling like before. The other option I have, that what we currently built in, is use the machine tool builder kinematics. That means, okay, I want to throw away the kinematics of the post builder here, which are defined in the post, and I want to use the kinematics of my machine tool here, and it will automatically use those one. One prerequisite is here for sure, a machine tool has to be loaded. Otherwise, when you click this, it will say, hey, no machine tool is loaded, so, and it will automatically keep the post builder variables. But in this step, let's use the post builder things. Click again. So this post processor don't contain any UDEs, that is why we don't can select any file here. So let over jump it. In the next step, you get a listing of the G and M codes, which are defined in the post builder processor, and you can say keep those settings, then it will overwriting the post configurator settings at the end. Or you can also say, hey, I want to use the standard post configurator settings, then you can uncheck it and it will not overwrite. But in standard, I think because G and M codes you defined before, you want to keep it. So, clicks the next step. That's the last step at the end. Now saying the output folder. Okay, that is here. And let's put it in converted post. Post processor name is automatically the same as before. For example, if you like, for if you have a kid, then you want, don't want to redefine the naming and so on. Let me create a subfolder. And now I click on this create post. Takes a second, and the post is created. That means when I now open post configurator here, because I have, at the end we use the NX Open RP for that. And because I create the post processor in this session here, I directly have it now in the list here. So open that one. And for example, we have directly the definition of the correct machine mode, machine type, the correct access definition that is from the post builder post processor. With the limit definition which was defined in the post builder processor. In this case, for example, it has limits and it can only rotate in a positive direction. If I have would create the post processor with the machine tool kinematics, then the fifth axis is unlimited for the SIM8, for example. Just to show this. So let me do the same again, but a little bit quick faster with the customer PP I mentioned before, because there's one major point, and then maybe we can start some discussions on that. What you think should be definitely inside of it, and I can also tell some additional problems we currently have here, or challenges. It's more challenges. So PP customer post, open this one. So, for example, here now you see I have the controller type because this was created origin one in NX9, I think, and the post builder version then contains the controller type. That means if it contains the controller type like Cinumeric 840D, the next step then automatically my Cinumeric is selected. So, go to the next step. I want to also keep the post builder kinematic in this case. And now this is the important one. The UDE settings, that is what I want to show. if there are multiple CDL files, it will show multiple CDL files. I can select this file and I get a list of all the containing UDEs. In this case, I mean, this is German. Sorry, guys. But at the end, these are customer-specific UDEs, which a lot of functionalities and a lot of huge amount of event handler. We will show C in a second. So click next step. I want to keep the G&M codes, same again, let me save this one. Demo, converted post, okay, create a subfolder and create this one. And now you see I have it in the list now, DST, that's a vertical lace. And the point I want to show now, what we did here, on the one side, all the UDEs are included. That means when I now go to the user-defined event editor, directly all the UDEs are included. The one thing is the user interface, or what I see in the user interface. The other thing is the TCL handler of that. So, and what we automatically did, we pass at the end also the TCL file and get all the information of the event handlers directly. That means it will automatically now create a file, like a layer. It's UDE event handler post builder TCL. And when I go into that file, you see I have at the end the event handler of the UDE. Like this mom, what we in German it's Abgleich, it's a German word, and at the end it calls a custom procedure, this PB CMD MLH Abgleich UDE. That is the, like the structure we have in Post Builder. And if I now let me search in this file for it, and now I have the complete event handler and can be directly executed. That means if now the user adds the UDE, it will execute it. And output the same behavior as before. And similar to that, what we did now with the UDE here, We plan it for custom commands, but for custom commands it will be, I think it will be difficult. And if you have any good idea what how to sort it, how to get the correct custom commands, or maybe you say, hey, I want to maybe shows which commands going over and which are not. That would be really good feedback if you have something of that. Okay, so yeah, that first brings me end to for example, this also one smaller issue. We have to work on the machine type. So the machine mode is, for example, it's set correctly to turn. That's right, but the machine type here it's wrong. It's not a three-axis mill. It's a two-axis lathe, right? So, but as I said, it's still in progress. Everybody who is interested in that, in general, we can provide. Okay. First, any questions? Have a lot of background noise. Okay. So if there are not specific questions to the converting tool, as I said, if you have any feedback to that or any idea what you think, I really be happy if we you can share this feedback. If you can share it now, you can share it per mail, you can share it in the forum. As I said, we still working on that, and maybe we can take an additional look for this converting in the next webinar and what is the progress here.
Thomas, I do have a question.
Yes.
All those settings, are they filled in the user interface through the DLL, or is it in the TCL in the background? Because currently you cannot interact with the interface with any NX Open APIs.
Right. First, that was changed, or that is changed. So the NX Open API is extended with 8047, if I remember correctly. So you can set properties with NX Open.
I tried to do it, but I couldn't find how to.
Okay, let me. I can send you a sample then. Okay,
Okay, thank
how
you.
to do that? But I think, if I remember correctly, we introduced it with 8047. Maybe if I'm wrong, then it's latest 1872. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. Okay. So Pierre, why the question? Yeah, good question, Pierre. If you have a linked post, I think this is also very challenging. What I think. Or I have in mind here, I mean, if you have a link post, you have two definitions of post processor, right? So it means you define maybe different kinematic settings, and to convert this to post configurator, then at the end we have to add this chain and automatically set those chain properties. That is may the way how to solve it, and I can imagine that this will be possible. But as I said, it's really challenging.
It's Pierre here. It's maybe better to start from the post configurator if you have too many link posts.
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, okay, good.
Think
Thank you.
so. You're welcome. Okay. That's from Magnus, a good question. So for sure, Inspect Tool will working also for two-channel machines, and so this is definitely something we implement. What I just wondering was show where output comes from, because maybe some of the confusion I want to make clear here. So in this debugging, you have this property show where output comes from. Before we have the inspect tool, this was the one how to detect what you want to change in a post processor, and you get a really unreadable at the end text file with this, all this information, with newer versions, use the inspect tool. Don't use the show where output comes from. This one is more confusing instead of using the show inspect tool. And yeah, as I said, in a multi-channel case, it's inspect tool working. But I'm unsure if it will not working in Sync Manager directly. But there's also a plan to change this behavior in general, so yeah.
It's Magnus here, Thomas.
Okay. Ah, yeah, I see it. Yeah, I don't want to read the instant messenger.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, good. Oh, sorry. Yeah, because when I'm using the two channel, when I'm creating and use ANSI program with two channels, upper and lower, for example.
Right. Also, I say in Sync Manager, the inspect tool is not working because the post processing is it's different there. If you only post process the operations with a two channel machine, not in sync, then you have the inspect tool. If you are in Sync Manager, you don't have it because the process is different. But as I said, this is at the end there's a refactoring plan for that for the whole Sync Manager. And then we will also take care on that, definitely from the post-processing side that you can inspect, because I know that is annoying when you don't can inspect the data, right?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, so then there was one additional question from Jim. Like putting conditions with the line. Okay, so yeah, good point. That's really good feedback, Jim, from you. So we are still working on things like that you easily can add conditions. For sure, I know, in PostBuilder you just click on edit, condition, and then put the TCL code. This is currently, as I said, not possible, but it's a good thing definitely to have this as an enhancement in the future. That means that you can, for example, say, okay, make a right mouse button click here, and then I can say, create a condition, and then it will output the things or not. But currently, this is not. You have to use, like, in this thing, because it's at the end TCL, you have to use an if condition and then do it or not.
Thomas, I didn't find, but maybe it works. How we can restrict amount of UDs? Because for particular machine, I probably don't want to use all system by default UDs.
So I hope I get it correctly. So you want to avoid much UDs, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Okay. So, I mean, this is one of the major purposes or values of PostConfigurator. Therefore, you have the properties. You can because normally UDEs, from my experience, sometimes you need UDEs. There's no way around. You need them. It's so. But in most of cases, like header of programs, like multiple cooling settings, whatever, you can easily build them up with own properties. And this is a standard, and the user don't have to add UDEs. And additionally on that, and that is a really cool thing from my perspective, you as a post developer can say, hey, the user don't see, for example, controller capabilities, general setting, motion settings, cycle settings. He can only see, for example, this, like the things we created. So he only see maybe this rapid customizing command block, even if it make no sense. Or you allow the user only to say, where we have such a thing with general, like here in the coolant. You only show to the end user or that it's possible. You only show those properties, and because sometimes you have the situation as customer said, yeah, but sometimes I mean in 90% I need it the output in this case. But there are 10% I want to have the other case. So and then you can say, okay, customer, I allow you, no problem. You can change the property directly in the UI of PostConfigurator. if you want. And then you don't need any UDEs for the coolant, for example. But this is really something depends on the case. And from my personal experience, you can get rid of 70% of UDEs normally. You don't need them anymore.
Yeah, I understand. I mean that when you assign some UDEs to any object in CAM environment, you have list of all UDEs, system, custom, and other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So how can we regulate the amount of UDEs in this particular list?
Because
in, for example, in PostBuilder, you cannot touch the CDL file by your own, and in that case, you will see probably 3 or 4 UDEs for these particular machines, and that's all.
Mm-hmm. I mean, this is one version away, unfortunately. You can switch off CDL files at the end. So, for example, I don't want to have the standard UDEs, right? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, this is the most common use case, I think. I don't want to have the standard UDEs. Let me open shortly the Labo Machine Install Sim 8. So, in Post Configurator, currently, as I said before, we really have the layer manager. We have this main definition file, the sim8mil5x cinematic dev. Inside of that one, all CDL and dev files are sourced. Means if I want to get rid of this standard UDEs, you can just comment out them here. It doesn't matter. It not hurt. But currently, you have to do it in the main definition file at the end.
Okay.
But if you do that and you update your libraries, you overwrite that information. So that's the risk if you do that.
That's the risk currently, right?
And do I understand right that kinematic that post configurator? Obtain kinematic from can do it. Obtain kinematic directly from tool model. Yep.
Yes.
In the moment of creation.
Right.
So if I at that point it becomes disconnected from the kinematic model.
Currently, yes.
So So, in case of using the different device that changes kinematic, right, like heads,
mm-hmm.
Maybe, and for example, heads, see? Can we do right now the post with post configurator or not?
Yes. So, therefore, we have this multi-chain feature. And post configured.
Mm-hmm.
So that means you define multiple chains for different heads, and each head have a different kinematic, right? So maybe the spindle axis is the initial spindle axis is in a different direction, the vector is in a different way.
Okay.
That is what you can do with this multi-chain feature in post configurator. I really recommend this. I think I showed something in the first session of that, and also in the manufacturing forum. There's one training part of a multi-chain. And if you like, I can also send additional trainings material to that, if you want.
I guess I've found this in previous sessions.
Okay. I mean, there's one for... Shortly.
And right now, all settings that we configure with graphical user interface, it is storing in the encrypted files.
Mm-hmm. It's not, no, wait. I mean, let me send you the link versus a multi-chain, okay, but to answer this this question. So if you change something in the user interface, then it's normally stored in this, for example, the post name underscore custom PCE file, right? This is encrypted, yes, but what is stored in this file, it's how to set the property at the end. So that means it's the object name, then a set, then the property name, and then the value. If you want that those settings, maybe it's a small trick here. The disadvantage on that is, for example, let me switch it off. So now this property, I change it, right? The lock is open. And it's saved in this custom PCE file. When I don't want that, for example, when I deliver the post processor to the customer or whatever, then I want maybe that the lock is closed, because otherwise I don't get the feedback if it changed or not, whatever. There's one small trick I want to shortly show, and if you don't get it directly, then can also share it again in the forum then. So what you have to do is just add a TCL file with the name of the post processor in your post processor, then 123 underscores custom level export, that's the name, TCL.
Should be 3 underscores exactly.
Yes. I can also mention that in the complete conclusion of this meeting, if you like. When I know save this post processor, you get a question here. Do you want to export those settings? That means the settings which you have done in the UI into this TCL file. When you now say yes, and go back to this post processor, so this is the TCL file, open that file, and now you get all the settings we did. So that means now I get this conf control coolant set auto coolant auto 0, because that is what I changed in the UI. And for example, this one you can use and now add this in your layer, and it will automatically set before.
Okay.
And the same for like the properties I created in the session here, right? These are this start of program before, start of program after. And you can just copy it, put it in TCL, and in standard it's set then.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so we have running out of time a little, but okay, two additional questions, one from you. I will be the question when we create PC post. Can use. That's for you. That's, I think, the answer is easy. At the end, the post processor folder. So if you create a post processor, all the time, the complete folder. There's one disadvantage, I think, in older versions, you don't have this create subfolder option. So when you create a post processor, all the time, I only can recommend it, create a new folder, go in this folder, and create the post processor in that folder. And if you deliver the post processor, when you create the post processor, like I did with this converted post here, let me, like this one, at the end, all the files in the folder of this DST 4C4600 belongs to this post processor. So if you want to use it, copy the complete folder. You need all of the files.
One question more.
Okay. Sure. No problem. You're welcome.
I have been developing my project for last 3 weeks, and I faced with very unpleasant situation when the post processor crashed, you know, and it hasn't any backups. And I am lucky that I know what I changed. Mm-hmm. But in the case when I don't know where to search the mistakes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, And
it didn't open my post processor, no.
I mean, this is a native problem of NX Core at the end and the architecture we have in this MOM. for example, when I do like this, I mean, I know the error here, right? I just remove this quotes. When I now post process, I get a TCL error. So it's saying nothing, right? It's just saying MOM TCL interpreter returned error when doing event. Okay. So, and the only real help currently is the syslog file at the end. There you get all the information normally you needed. That's the only place where you can get a point where it is crashed. That means go to the end of the file. Directly after the crash, scroll a few lines up. And then you get a lot of TCL errors here. And what I mean, it's like, we are all humans, it's also similar way. So if you get the errors, go up to the top of this errors, and then normally when this you have this TCL error, event handler tells you the file, scrolling to the right, and then it's saying, okay, MOM start of program, in this case error missing quotes. And that means something in the start of program and I missed some quotes. When you read the next line, then you see, normally you see the command, the command, maybe it's a missing variable, whatever. In this case, it's MOM output literal, something. And then it tells you, okay, this is the property, which is, and there it is defined because I removed this quote. But this is really, yeah, you have, to be honest, this is try and error here. But the information, what is really happens here, you only get from here. This is the place where you get the information. Nowhere else.
Okay.
Okay.
I still have a question about the usability, if there's time for it.
Yes, but first let me, before Sven, just give me, because Merrick have also, I think, one question. Okay, so a short answer for Maverick directly, with this disadvantage of version control system. Yes, currently I agree to that. That's the problem. But we are working currently also on that, and this will be available in next future. That you really see the tracking changes of all the things, when it changed, who changed it, and so on. So then... Again, you were shortly. Yeah, okay. Also, for you were short answer, yes, you just copy the entire folder. And also, as I mentioned, the post configurator post are the same architecture. That means for post configurator post, you have also one main TCL file and one main definition file. That is what native and X need. And in post configurator, for example, this post processor, it's normally the file with this post processor name, this DST TCL, and the dev file. And also with post configurator in your machine database, machine.file, you also enter with the same name. And those both files are sourcing all the rest of the additional folders. You're welcome. Okay, so then, Joel, okay, yeah, that's a bug, and it's solved in 8072, that all NC code will be visible definitely in the inspect tool. So, and now Sven, for the,
okay.
The last question so today.
Yeah.
Okay.
So when you're using the inspect tool, when you click on post process, you get the NC output and you get the NC the inspect tool. But you only want to see the inspect tool. The post output doesn't matter because it's already inside the inspect tool.
Mm-hmm.
So is there a possibility to turn off the NC output and only see the inspect tool?
Currently not, but I will let me write it down and I will check this with developer.
Okay.
Okay,
And
but currently I think it's not possible.
Okay, and in PostConfigurator we have a lot of windows. So we have the main window, we have the window of the inspect tool, maybe the TCL window. In the future, is there going to be the possibility to dock those windows, like with the Windows Explorer style?
Yeah, sure. I mean, possible is everything, right? it's a good feedback. Let me also show you that you have like docking windows like the Explorer, right?
Yeah, it's good that we have all the windows and we can use them all
yeah,
the
but,
same.
But sometimes it's too much.
I'm constantly moving around windows and searching for the right one. So that I think that's still a problem
okay.
for the usability.
Okay,
and then the last one, when we send a post to the customer, we encrypt the post processor, then we go to the folder. We need to copy the entire folder, remove the PCL file, so only the PCE files are used. I think there could also be an enhancement. Be great.
Okay.
Maybe create a folder to send to the customer with everything inside it, maybe a zip file or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good feedback, yeah. Encryption. Okay, so, yeah, to just remove, or that's automatically removed, right? Or that you just say, I want to...
Yeah, but put it in a different folder. But
yeah, in a different folder.
Because we need the post with the TCL files, not the PCE files, to edit them.
Right. Okay. Yeah, like a publish button or something, right? So I click on this
something
publish button,
like
and
that,
then
yeah.
it's will encrypt it. Will only bring the files which are encrypted to this folder. Hmm? Get
yeah.
it? Cool idea.
And remember the what is it called? The ID, Salto ID.
Yes.
Currently, you have to put it in every time.
I know. That's definitely on my list.
Okay.
That's definitely on our list. So. That will be happens, and then maybe it's a good point to also directly do that, because I think it's not magic to do that. Okay,
that was it for me. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for the feedback. Okay, so then we still running out of time here today, 20 minutes, but doesn't matter. Yeah, thank you for the participation. Thanks for this feedback today. And hope you enjoy this session. And as every time, I will upload it latest on next week, Monday. So have a nice weekend. Bye.
Many thanks, Thomas, for this session.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.